Thank you for being here, Parji Sanamkoko. I don't know the heading of this video, but it has been so long since when I created videos. Welcome to Tanzania, guys. Tanzania, right now it's summer. It's shining. We have no rainfall. As you can see outside, it is very, very, very dry. This is Tanzania. I'm in my studios. My studios are found in Dar es Salaam. Please go and watch the videos that I posted. People from Tanzania, go check those videos, watch them. It's not too late. YouTube is for all the generations. Once you create a video and you say I'm posting it on YouTube, then it's for all the generations. I created my YouTube channel in 2020. My dad passed away after finishing my senior 60 studies, missing out the loan. I never joined the university, so I decided to join the military, perhaps to become a soldier or a policeman. I started making money, but the first thing that I thought in my head, making memories would be a good time. I'm really nervous. Sometimes it takes me a long time to be happy to create such videos because I don't get people to speak with English for a long time. I was in an area whereby at least half of my day is spent by speaking English. I think I would have finished this video and you would have been watching another video. You can succeed in YouTube in a very short period of time because, for example, you open up a YouTube channel and say, I want to go and climb Mount Kilimanjaro. The first person who will open that YouTube video, that person is going to watch more than 1 minute because you're exposing something that is very unique. We have very many places in our country that can make a YouTuber very successful within a very short period of time. After opening my YouTube channel in 2020, very many things were happening in my life at that time because I had exited the military. I had to move, go find a job. The first time I began riding boda boda at Chamwino Ikulu. I have a vlog that I created. I'm showing it right now here. I created this vlog in the streets that for the last time I was in the military. So I spent my time traveling around Tanzania. Seeing how Tanzania is beautiful. You know, when you're in the military, you're going to get a chance of traveling around the country. When you shift from one area to another, you experience the lifestyle of other people very different. They live in a different way. They speak a different language. They grow different crops. So this started growing my amnesty towards YouTube. How am I going to visit these places and make memories that I once stepped here? I know this road comes from this place and ends here. So Tanzania is full of magical things. On my YouTube videos, I want to speak exactly a story that made me be an interviewer. Love interviewing people. You know, after opening my YouTube channel, I created enemies automatically, and enemies are going to come from every corner. There are people who don't want to be on camera. There are people who really don't want this kind of lifestyle. This is a very big point. I never wanted to talk about it, but let me talk about it. It is very important. It is very crucial. That's why I really turned into interviews. When you're vlogging, when you're moving in the streets, be aware there are very many people with very many types of jobs. They are going to come up to you. Hey guy, what are you doing? This world is already a lot of war. Anytime, this world is already a lot of high security. People are working day and night to keep this peace and security. And for Tanzania, keeping peace and security is something very profitable for the country more than anything else. If you're seen with the camera, you really need to have documents in your pocket. So vlogging becomes very hard because in most places whereby you need to get clean content, there are people to ask you questions like that. Those are the very places those people locate themselves. They are there to watch those places, not to be a target of bad people. So you really need to continue liking our videos, commenting, so that you give us the energy to bring videos through monetized work. This brings me to something that I want to talk about. Being an interviewer came from a reason called English. English is a language, but today it becomes a reason in my video because I really need to talk about this English in a very special way. Thank you, God. I really thank you, God, the one who is giving me right now the breath
to breathe. I really thank you. In all names, thank you, God, for making me know how to speak English very well, listen to it, and perhaps interpret it into another language. I might not be doing it at 100%, and I've already given you the reason before. When you're around Kiswahili speakers, or perhaps other people who speak other types of languages, as you know, Tanzania has a lot of tribes. So in other parts of the city, you might find a certain tribe has occupied a very big place, so they are speaking their language. So this really spoils someone's English. But I'm telling you, something that someone went at school and learned to senior sixth grade can never die. I believe in my heart, I'm a very nice debater. I'm a very nice English speaker. So that brings me to becoming an interviewer. I thought I must use my language. I must use the way I understand these white people, these other nations talking and trying to put out some knowledge about some things. Because, for example, on one of my YouTube videos, I was explaining on how to use such gears. For example, using such gears. My YouTube channel was set to use English. So that's why I don't want to spend a long time without posting a video talking to my English fans. People really need to learn Swahili. People really need to learn the same English I'm speaking right now. But I've not met the right people. I've not met the right chance for this pure belief that is in me to come out. In my YouTube videos, you are going to see a video with over 25,000 views. That was a miracle. I don't make those views now, but you're going to see me having a video on my YouTube channel with 25,000 views, and it is an interview. So that means I had a chance to talk to a person who had an audience. People wanted to listen to him, what he was about, where he was. And this interview is one of the strong interviews that I have on my YouTube channel. You're listening to my pure mind. You're listening to the way I'm varying things. You're listening to the way I purify things. That means I'm pure. You're listening to pure information. You're being attached to someone that you listen to pure information. I don't know if you can try to feel the way I really believe that I'm talking to someone, and someone might come up with the point and say, yo, we need to listen more about this. I'll come up with a specific title and say, this is the title of the video. But because it was very long without me posting a video, then I decided to come up and say, why don't I create a video and say, why did I become an interviewer? Why did I become an interviewer? Why do I always like making videos, talking to people, asking people questions about what they've been through, their love, their pain? That means because I've not had the right person to give me that chance. So I decided to create the environment to give that chance to another person. That was the reason behind. And through this YouTube video, guys, I'm going to come up again with stories simple like this. Let me say, I want to say thank you very much for the four people who have liked my past video. You guys, thank you very much. One of them is me. I don't know who the other three people are, but you guys, thank you very much. You're four beautiful people, me being one of them. We have liked our video locally in the studio about Simon the designer, the guy who designs stages where musicians dance and make flows. So, Johar Jisanamko, Mambo Vipi, Habari za wakati huu. For today, let me end there. It has been 20 minutes me talking to you, or less, I don't know, but approximately it has been 20 minutes me talking to you, trying to tell you why I'm an interviewer. A big point being, in my heart, I feel I should give something. I should give out something that I really missed. Someone listening to me at my early time, at my prime time, at my very early age. Who you wanna be, what you wanna do, where you wanna be. Perhaps of more stories that I'll be coming up with. Things would have never ended like this. Perhaps they would have been more, perhaps they would have been lesser. I have very many stories to tell. You're going to meet them in two languages, English and Swahili. You're going to meet me interviewing people. The life that I'm living right now is nice compared to what I'm seeing outside the environment that I'm living. I've been to very many places in this country. As I told you before, I've been to the military. I've been traveling around this country with a train in some time, making interviews. So I've seen how life is hard in my country. This life I'm living, guys, just like my videos. I need nothing from you. Comment on my videos. What story do you need? Where do you want me to take you? Life is hard, harder, and most pure, hardest for the people who are living in Africa. Why? I don't know. Let's join our interviews. Let's join our life. Let's create a community of talking to each other, of advising each other. Life will be one day good. I believe so. See you in another time. I want to thank all my friends who miss me and love me. Life is taking us through very many places. The people have been with Kigoma, traveling around with you. All the MCs that we have had a chance to talk together. All the people I'm trying to crack and ask for some help through social media. The only possibility, the only help you can give me is reposting my video on your platform. Nothing else. I know I'm going to get the people I need. There are people who really have some stories behind their back and they really need those stories out. That's all I need. There's no story that is going to be heard when someone is in the grave already. That's why you're going to see me making interviews. Johari Jisanamko, Mambo Vipi, Karibu Sana, subscribe, nitakuona kwa wakati mwingine. Bye. I love you guys. This is UTV.